हेलो, गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स। हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड स्टेइंग होम टू कीप योर सेल्फ सेफ फ्रॉम COVID-19, वेयरिंग मास्क एंड सैनिटाइजिंग योर हैंड टाइम टू टाइम। सो लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट आवर चैप्टर एग्रीकल्चर। एज इन द प्रीवियस मॉड्यूल वी हैव कंप्लीटेड अप टू द cereal crops. Here in this module we are going to discuss about the fiber crops and beverages crops. So let us start. The first one is that fiber crop. As here in the figure you can see, this is a cotton. So we are going to start first about the cotton. So fiber can be divided. Fiber crops can be divided into category, that natural fiber and artificial. So two types of fibers are there here. This, as these plants are naturally growing, so the fiber comes from these are the natural fibers, and artificials which are developed by different petrocarbons like plastic, polythene, or you can say nylon, rayon. So that are artificial or synthetic fibers. Here natural fibers are cotton, jute, natural silk and wool. Artificial fibers are rayon, nylon and terricot. So cotton require different climatic condition, and in that first one is the soil type. So alluvial and black soil are ideal for its cultivation. Temperature, it is a crop of tropical and subtropical regions. It requires temperature 30 to 40 degrees Celsius. Rainfall, it grows well in regions of 60 to 100 centimeter of annual rainfall. During the harvesting period, weather should be dry, frost free, means though no fall of fog, and sunny, clear sky should be there. Areas in the world where it is grown well, that are China, India, USA, Pakistan, Brazil, Uzbekistan, Turkey and Australia. Areas in India, Gujarat, Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Punjab, Haryana are the main cotton producing states. So cheap and efficient labor is required for plucking cotton balls in our country, and it is mainly grown under irrigation. So this cheap and efficient labor is very much required, as there the farmers need to pluck all these cotton balls, these whatever the flowers are there, means cotton is looking here. This is only known as cotton ball, and this is plucked by the farmers or laborers manually, each one. So that way here use labor required, and they should be skilled also, and that should be cheaper in rate also, because the labor requirement is higher, and if that labor will be costly, so the production of this cotton can be very costly. So it is grown mainly in with the help of irrigation facility, because as you know that not very humid climate or not very dry climate, there should be all these requirement of irrigation facility in proper condition. So this way this is growing with irrigation facility. Now jute. So jute plant you can see here, This is a pick from somewhere. In this, see this first plant. These plants are cut, and after cutting, that bundles are making and dip into the water of pond, river, whichever facility is required available, and that are left there for few days so that the bark of this stem of this jute rot in that water, soak water and become soft, and afterward that are taken out and dried in the sun, and then such kind of jute fiber we get, and then this is used for different purposes. For growing jute, the soil type required is alluvial, found in river delta. It grows well in flood plain areas, wherever the flood comes, good supply of rainwater is there. So those areas are well for this. Usually this is growing in the kharif crop season. So this way, flood plain areas are ideal for this production. Temperature required. So jute crop requires more than 25 degrees Celsius temperature. Rainfall. Annual rainfall should be more than 150 centimeter. Areas in the world where this is grown very well, so that are India, Bangladesh, China, Ivory Coast of Thailand, Myanmar, Ivory Coast, it is a country only, Thailand, Myanmar, Brazil are the main countries. Areas in India. India is one of the leading producer. Actually, it is the second largest producer of jute in the world, because first largest producer is that Bangladesh. In India, jute is cultivated in Ganga Brahmaputra Delta of West Bengal. It also Assam, Bihar, Meghalaya, Odisha are producing jute. Other areas than these also are growing that jute for their different purposes, but these are usually growing for the trade purpose. Now beverages crops. So beverages crops, you know, that crops which are used for making drinks, that drinks other than that which you think not a soft drink, this is a edible, means you can say peene like cheeze banai jati, so that are beverages crops. Tea and coffee, these two crops are taken as beverages crops. So here in the figure you can see, as this is a hilly area and there is good slope, so such kind of hilly areas are ideal for this, and then these are grown in this way. You have studied about contour plowing, so this contour plowing is used. Even you can say step cropping also here can be taken, and see, these are grown in such a way that the people can move in between, so that they can easily pluck the leaves required, and such kind of things are there. So let us first talk about the tea. So this tea required the soil type, a deep, well-drained, fertile soil. It's good for crop. Temperature, it grows well in hot, humid conditions of the tropical and subtropical regions. Temperature requirement is about 20 to 30 degrees Celsius. Now, rainfall, it needs about 150 to 300 centimeter of annual rainfall. Hilly slopes, as I told you here, hilly slopes are ideal for its cultivation. Region behind this hilly slope, that the roots of these tea are not able to survive in the stagnant water. If water stagnant there, means water is staying there, water logging is there, so the tea plant cannot survive in that area. That is why this such kind of slopes are taken, and good supply of water, rainfall is required. As here you can see, 150 to 300 centimeter annual rainfall required. So there water is also required more, but water logging should not be. Areas in the world: China, India, Kenya, Sri Lanka, Turkey, Indonesia, Vietnam, Japan, Iran, Argentina are the leading producer of tea. Similarly, areas in India, Assam, Kerala, Tamil Nadu and West Bengal are major tea producing states. Now, coffee. So here a plant of coffee you can see there. Fruits are there, coffee fruits, and then such kind of coffee beans are taken out and roasted, and then their powders made, and we are using that coffee. So soil type, coffee needs a well-drained, fertile soil in the hilly slopes. So this is also grown in the hilly region. Temperature required is 15 to 28 degrees Celsius. Coffee plant need hot and humid climate, and that way temperature you can see here, not more required and not less required, hot but humid. Because of this humidity, temperature is not going to very high range and not going to very low range. So 15 to 28 degrees Celsius, the temperature required. Now rainfall. See here, rainfall is also required 150 to 200 centimeter. So that way, rainfall required more, but here also the plants are growing well where no water logging take place. So this way hilly region is suitable for this. Irrigation is required where the annual rainfall is less than 100 centimeter. So wherever this is grown and rainfall is less, so irrigation can help for the growth of such coffee plant. So areas in the world are: Brazil is the leading producer of coffee in the world. Vietnam, Colombia, Indonesia, Ethiopia, India, Honduras, Uganda, Mexico are the other main coffee producing countries. Areas in India, major coffee producing states of India are hilly regions of Karnataka, Kerala and Tamil Nadu. So this way, here we completed the topics. So some more topics, I think one topic left, so we'll discuss that topic in the next module. So students, treat these topics which we have discussed here and revise that. Thank you. Have a nice day.